Hello, Pisces. Thank you for clicking on my channel. Welcome to the journey home. My name is Catherine and I live in Nova Scotia. This is your Zodiac Tarot forecast for the dates January 23rd or 24th to February 6th, 2 weeks ahead. I'm so sorry, Pisces. I forgot to shuffle up your oracles. Pick one, Catherine. The Sorceress and the Weaver. Let's take them both. And I won't read from the book. I'm just going to read the energy or feel the energy here. And for the Celtic, I shouldn't leave the Celtic tree oracle out. Maybe I'll just do a quickie on that one. Thank you, Spirit. The Celtic oracle tree you got. Oh, Code Grove. You got the Grove. Let's have a look. This is number 21. Feelings I get off of that right off the bat without reading it, because I've never drawn this card before, is finding your tribe, being in the Grove. Really? Where's my glasses? Aren't I ever prepared for this? I've done a whole bunch of signs. There they are. I've done a whole bunch of signs, so you're the last one. But you're always the best. Never fear. 21. Let's grab a bit of this message here. We are the Grove and we send you love. We hold you and ground you. What is your favorite grove? Where, whatever it is, wherever it is, a grove of trees is a holy place. Make time to find a group of trees and sit among them. That's right in my backyard. My backyard is a grove of trees. Attune yourself to the inner silence and open the portal of the grove with an invitation. Ooh, yes. Ask the trees if they will spend some time with you. They do every day. We appreciate such an invitation. We lead you straight into your heart and into the realm of no space and no time and the dimensions of higher love, understanding, insight, and possibility. Feel into this dimension. From here, we can direct you towards people, places, and situations that will bless you. We can guide you towards your own expression of divinity. We can help you contemplate the mysteries of the magic of existence. This place is always available to you. We invite you to come and sit with us anytime you do so desire. Here at the portal of the Grove and within your own heart, we invite you to open to the light. We come from expanded awareness and we return to expanded awareness. This is available to you as well. Do not fear. Sit quietly and we will help you recognize and align to your sacred purpose. We will help you to stay on your true path and know your power as a spiritual being. Here in the holy darkness of the closing of the Celtic year, breathe in the deep, chilling air and give your gratitude. Light a candle and know that you are a flame of love and purpose. We will help you grow. We will help you to grow in your resolve. We will help you to know exactly what is right for you in the next moment and all the moments to come. I think you found your tribe. And Pisces, being a water sign, this is earth energy. Earth energy. Go for a walk in the woods. Do just what that oracle said. Something. Just I've got goosebumps all over me right now. All over me. Now, with the Sorceress, I would think very much, I mean, look at this. This is like two Pisces cards right here. The Sorceress reminds me of the High Priestess and the Weaver, of course. Pisces is the Dream Weaver. Pisces, I think the earth was created by the Pisces spirit simply because of the imagining, and being able to bring it into physical form. I love how water and earth work, you know, where the imaginings, the inspirations being brought to 3D, earth energy into the 3D. In between, we've got fire, which is purification, passion, and air, which is the mechanics, the thought patterns of bringing it into reality. So for the weaver, we've got your inherited aspects of your family's honor and word. This is fate, destiny. The actions of your ancestors have had a ripple effect on your life, and you have worked through some of this impact with strength and nobility. What have we talked about so often about paying ancestral karmic debts? There may be more work to do yet. You have free will, and you also have a destiny. It's like, wow, Pisces, you accomplished so much. You want to do it again? You want to do some more? And you're like, can I take a break? Can I just like enjoy the reward for a wee while? And before we get into the next phase of, you know, cliff climbing. You have free will and you also have a destiny. And the two dance together and form a pattern that is unique to you. And this is your contribution to the web of word. Every action has an impact. Every choice will create results that are impossible to see now. So consider the choices before you and choose what is the highest good for all. What is the most honorable and beyond the personal? Ask no person to give up their personal honor to further your own ambitions. Consider the impact of your choices into the future and consider the ancestors and what they would feel about your choices. You shall now choose well. For you are weaving the world that was, weaving the present moment, and weaving the world that shall be. What happens to one of us in our country, town, family happens to us all. Every act vibrates throughout this universe and on this great energetic web. And we are in every moment, with every word and every thought and every deed contributing to this great grid of energy. Wow. So sorceress is about rituals, power, and will. I think it has everything. The connection here is with the grove. So yeah, go back, rewind to the beginning with the grove to see the connection here. It's time for you to act, to gather together your wisdom in an organized and structured manner and create a moment of power. Wasn't that long ago we did a reading where it said that spirits were all gathering, the universe was gathering forces, you know, like the lightning bolt, to gather all the forces together to give you that help because you were about to execute something important. Gather together your energy, plan your strategy, and set your goals. Choose your time and choose your tools and meet with all the power you can gather. Before this meeting, whisper to yourself of your goals and your powers. Be sure to fill yourself up with strength and conviction. Raise your head high, straighten your back, set your shoulders, and do not allow any doubt to creep in at this time. Do your homework to be prepared. And then when the moment comes, let all this energy and power and self-belief flow out in a very smooth manner. This will help you through a job interview, a case that needs to be made, and gathering together allies and others who believe in you. It will also counteract any kind of self-doubt, negativity, or jealousy that may have been impeding your progress until this point. Every ritual of self-empowerment will be divinely blessed at this time. You must work at bringing back your own power, at harnessing your strong and potent will, which has until this time been neglected and underestimated. You are a being of power and commitment. Let us see what you can do when you believe in yourself at last. Do I even have to go on with this reading? That was a mouthful. That was a full reading in itself, Pisces. But let's get on to the Zodiac Tarot portion of your reading. Wow, I'm just blown away by that. Blown away. I don't even know it. Probably have to put that in the title. Blown away. Overall energy, bottom of the deck, page of earth, an offer coming in. This is also about leveling up, guys. So I think we've got some accumulation of energies coming in. And they didn't say it was going to explode, did they? They said it was going to move out in a smooth manner. So you're leveling up here. Could be going back to school. I always have trouble with this card. And I always say I have trouble with this card. Because I haven't yet found the right words of what I feel when I see this card. Amazing. You were stuck for quite some time, it looks like, but you're becoming unstuck. Someone loves you a lot. They're there for you when you need them. This could be someone who, you know, gives you the best advice. They have great compassion. They're very controlled in their emotions. And they're there to help you if you need it and give you space when you need it as well. You have wish fulfillment coming in. If your wish was for a new love, Pisces, here it comes. Here it comes. Wish fulfillment with new love. This could be a wish fulfillment if you want renewed love, you know, or reconciliation. In a way, Pisces, I gotta tell you, just walk away. So many of you have started this path and you're now at a certain way down the road that it's not the time to look back. Just keep going. You have this two aces up on board now, this brand new beginning, this legacy building energy that's around you. When the Ace of Earth comes up, it's the Ace of Pentacles. This is a blessing from God saying, I am now going to bless you with abundance. For some of you, more abundance. And there's so much love here. There's so much love around you here. And now the sun. Good Lord. I mean, look at this first level. Just gotta show you here. Look at this first level. Wish fulfillment, two aces, and the sun. This is the happy card of the deck. The overwhelming, cup overflowing, joy, and just having love for everything and everyone, just saying, you know, I could just picture you walking down the wrong road, you know, like, bless you all, you know, good morning, have a wonderful morning. Just that energy of like, you're so full of joy, gratitude, being thankful for the blessings that you have. That you just want to spread the love. You're planting seeds. All right, let's start talking about, yeah, I'm just not getting it. Okay, you're planting seeds, which is bringing you to a crossroads. So these seeds that you planted have now brought you to a place where now you have to decide. Is it between two people, two jobs, two places to live? What is it? There is a crossroads that you're at. And you've got the third ace up now, Ace of Fire. Passionate new beginning. Inspiration. Inspiration. Being passionate about what you're doing. You make a judgment call here, and the judgment call here was that you decided on you because you felt left out in the cold, but you see your worth now. There's the three cards that say so. You felt left out in the cold, but you see your worth now. And you had to make a judgment call. Some of you are entrepreneurs, going after your goals, achieving them, making great achievements. This is also about being very attractive, charismatic, drawing attention. You walk in the room and people turn their heads, or you're noticeable. You could be, you're being noticed, whether it's publicly or group settings. But this, again, has to do with being in control of your future, your career, your life path. Very nice energy. Very nice energy, Pisces. These are incredible cards to show up. Like three aces, the sun, wish fulfillment, and so much love surrounding you. It's incredible. You have the love and support that you need, whether that's from the spirit realm or from people around you, but it's surrounding you. But at the heart of your reading, you're at a crossroads. You have to make a decision about something. What could that be? It's because you planted seeds. And those seeds are coming to fruition. And it's almost like, all right, picking a career, picking a job, picking a person. Could be a number of things, actually. Let's clarify these cards. Whatever you were stuck about, something happened. Someone came in with a message. It could have been a job offer. And said, here's a project that, you know that you can accomplish. So you're like, yeah, I'm on it, because I'm tired of being stagnant and stuck and achieving it. You've got the magician at the bottom of the deck. Manifestation, having all the tools that you need to go forward, accomplishments, achievements. Really big on the word achievements today, aren't I? Okay, let's talk about signs for just a minute. We see Scorpio, Leo, Virgo, Gemini, Aries. Cool. Let's go on. Aquarius. Wish fulfillment. And that wish fulfillment has something to do with your path. Something to do with a door opening so that you could walk through this portal. And it is on your path. It has a lot to do with healing. Going forward and looking back, saying, I forgive everything from my past. Going forward. It does have a lot to do, too, with choice. That free will choice. Do I go through that portal? Do I look back? Keep going, Pisces, keep going. Because this love that's coming in, this offer of love, this new love, this renewed love, this is divinely guided and has everything to do with divine timing. So I think what spirit is trying to tell you is the time is here. The time is trying to come in. If there is something that has kept you stuck, you're becoming unstuck. And once you're unstuck, there's no stopping you. But someone is going to be approaching you to tell you that they love you. That they love you immensely. That you are a soulmate. You're being divinely guided. And this has everything to do with divine timing. That time is coming. That time is finally arriving. It's at least trying to come in. What is it you're still holding on to that might be blocking it? This brand new beginning. Oh, for some of you, you see this brand new beginning and you're like, you see it coming. And you're like, I need a rest. Or I need to rest up. Or I need to prepare myself. It's like studying for the big exam that's coming up. The finals. The finals are coming up. And you're like, after the finals, and I know I'm going to ace it. It's the ace of coins, right? The ace of earth. I know I'm going to ace it. The finals coming up. But it's that anticipation and needing to withdraw and study, or withdraw and rest, or withdraw and rest and study. For those of you who were at the live stream, I said before I go on the live stream, like, the nervousness is just out of this world. It's like stage fright. And I was like, oh my God, I have to go in front of people and talk to them one-on-one. And what if the cards fly all over the place like they did the first live stream I did? Those cards ended up everywhere. It's like, oh God, what a klutz. So this is what I see you doing. It's like you're retreating to rest because you know you're hitting those final exams. And there's some spiritual healing taking place. I think it's during this time that the spirit blesses you so that when you come out of the gate, you come out first. You went through a complete transformation, Pisces. Look at that. You went through a complete transformation into the sun, into this new cycle, this new beginnings, this joy of who you are, having this joy of the path you're on, knowing that you're doing the right thing for the right reasons, and having the courage to do it. It hasn't been easy, Pisces. I know it hasn't been easy. But there was a lot of courage in doing it. It's like you knew who you were, but you hadn't done the finals yet to make that grade. And don't worry, you're going to ace it. You're going to ace it. Someone comes towards you. Oh, these seeds that were planted causes someone to come forward to make an offer of love. This could be you painting a whole new canvas, a talent that you didn't know you had. This crossroads that you're on right now, you're standing there at the crossroads and reflecting the pain of the past, saying, well, if I go down this path, what happens? If I go down this path, what happens? And am I picking the right path? Because in my past, I had so much hurt, so much pain, so much grief, so many regrets. You're going to choose the right path, whatever that is, Pisces. You have the Two of Cups here behind you. And once you get your paper back with the grade on it, ace, A plus, certified, crazy, you find that you're on your soulmate journey. And there's just a great feeling about that. You know, it doesn't matter if you're alone right now. It's just a good feeling to know that you're on a soulmate journey. Plus, you're fulfilling your destiny. There's no better, more honorable path than that. So someone comes in, someone comes racing in and say, Pisces, I've got this fabulous idea, and it's something you're really good at, and you know, it could make you money, or it could bring you love, or Pisces, I have this wonderful idea, let's go out, you know, to the top of the CN Tower and have dinner, something crazy, you know, like something fast, something exciting, something adventurous coming in, and it's something you can be passionate about. So if it's a project, you're going to be passionate about this project. You had to make a judgment call to cut something off. Wasn't easy, was it? You had to make a judgment call to stop hanging on to something, to cut something out that wasn't doing a damn thing for you. Not a damn thing. You tried and tried and tried. But if no effort is reciprocated, then you're just carrying around a dead branch that isn't bearing any fruit. And you're coming into a time of prosperity and fruit bearing and all kinds of opportunities. Let it go, Pisces. Look at you. Holy crumb. Look at you. Passionate new beginning. Why? Because you took on this Queen of Fire energy. That charismatic, attractive, magnetic, energetic, creative, divine feminine energy. For some of you, look at that Ace of Wands. Some of you, people of the opposite sex, are looking at you in a very sexual, sensual, boy, would I like to get with that Pisces. And Pisces says, catch me if you can. I'm on a path. Yeah, you were left out in the cold. There was shady behavior. This person was not honest with you, or was keeping things from you, or just wasn't open with you. They just left you out in the cold, but you see your worth now. We're going to clarify this over in the extended now. It's only $10 for the month. You get in for the whole month and access to all of the Zodiacs, all of the weekend forecast and the week ahead forecast. Personal readings are cheaper over there. And we give away gemstones every week at the live streams. I hope you join us on the live streams. They're 7 o'clock Atlantic Standard Time, 6 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And that's on YouTube, this channel. That's for everybody. And I pull cards for free for questions. Hope to see you on the other side, Pisces. God bless you. Thank you for your love and support. Hit the like, please. It does help my videos to get out there. And God bless you. Yeah. Bye.